Hello and welcome to this guide about the best marksmen in Mobile Legends of Season 22. In this video, we'll discuss 5 strong marksman heroes that are all great to use in certain situations. As a follower of this channel, you understand that choosing the right hero in the right situation is one of the most important aspects that can increase your chance of winning significantly. Therefore, I'll explain why those heroes are strong to use, in which situations you should pick them, and when you might avoid playing them. You can use this information to make sure you play the best marksman, so let's start right away. Okay, so we start this list with one of the strongest marksmen at the moment, Clint. He's currently one of the most banned marksman heroes, because he's able to deal a big amount of damage. A strong marksman needs high DPS, and Clint does meet this criteria. The main reason therefore is his passive. After casting a skill, Clint's next basic attack has a longer range, deals increased damage, and instead of only hitting one target, all enemies in a line will be hit. This isn't only strong in a teamfight, but it also makes Clint a great hero to take out the minions quickly, since they always walk in a line. His first skill is also a great way to take out the minions. By casting the skill, he fires 5 bullets in front of him that deal high damage. The first one always deals the full amount of damage. Well, if the same target is hit again, he receives reduced damage. So this skill is most useful when he's able to hit as many targets as possible, since they will all receive the full amount of damage. Then we have a second skill. This one doesn't deal that much damage, but it can save him when an enemy starts to come close to him. By casting the skill, he shoots a net towards the target that deals a small amount of damage and immobilizes him for 1.2 seconds. Meanwhile, Clint jumps back a small distance in the other direction. When he hits a target with his net, the cooldown of this skill gets reduced by 40%. His ultimate is the true skill that helps Clint to activate his passive often. His ultimate lets Clint stack grenades, which has a maximum of 5. Every grenade can be launched towards a target and deals physical damage and slows the enemy by 25%. The cooldown is very low when having a few grenades, which provides Clint with a very high DPS, since his skill will activate his passive every time. This skill makes Clint one of the best marksman heroes. He deals huge damage, has great range, and can also protect himself when an enemy comes close with his second skill. If we analyze in which situations you should pick Clint, he can be a great pick against heroes that have a short attack range. You can easily win your lane against heroes like Claude and Mia, but he's also great against fighters like Tarisla, Khalid, Leomord and Bauman. Then there are also a few heroes which are great friends of Clint. You have to look for the ones that use CC, so you can easily target them to unleash your bullets. This makes Clint great with heroes like Selena, Cho, Nana, Belleric and Tigreal. While Clint is a wonderful hero, he also has his weaknesses. Long range heroes or heroes with high burst damage can be quite dangerous. Be careful against heroes like Layla, Leslie, Hayabusa, Beatrix and Cecilion. With the right team composition, Clint is just a wonderful marksman that deals insane damage. The next hero also meets this criteria. Nathan has therefore also conquered a place in this list. He's one of the best marksmen at the moment and can be played both as a jungler and a side laner. Nathan doesn't only use physical, but also magic damage. That's one of the reasons he gets played as a jungler often. Since the new jungle mechanics, you now receive both magic and physical bonuses. If you buy the jungle boots and reach 15 stacks, you get 15 physical attack and magic power. Since Nathan used them both, he benefits double from this buff. He also has some great abilities that result in a very high DPS. The first cool thing is his passive. Every time Nathan or a clone hits an enemy, he gets increased attack and movement speed, which stacks up to 6 times. At 6 stacks, he gets 45% movement speed and 90% attack speed bonus, which is just insane. Then his basic attack will also return like a boomerang. This deals increased damage based on the physical attack and magic power. His first skill is very easy. This will just shoot a projectile in front of him to deal physical attack and magic power to enemies in his path. This skill can deal a good amount of damage. Then he also has his second skill, which is a CC skill. By casting it, Nathan fires a gravitation attractor which carries enemies along the path and deal damage. This is a great way to protect yourself when enemies try to reach you. Of course, Nathan wouldn't be complete without his ultimate. He can summon a clone that reverses his movement and copies his attacks. Cast the skill again, and Nathan switches places with his clone. The cool thing is that it also reduced the cooldown reduction of the other skills by 50%. So you probably understand that this hero is very powerful. He deals high damage, has strong CC skills, and is quite mobile. This makes him a perfect hero against any enemy that has no escape skill. Those heroes are easy to take down. Pick him against heroes like Nana, Gort, Angela, Layla, Mia and Cecilia. He's even better if your team consists of heroes that are able to send the enemy. This way, Nathan deals more damage since he now can cast his boomerang basic attack more effectively. Therefore, choose him with heroes like Atlas, Tigreal, Ruby and Cecilian. A big weakness of Nathan are heroes with CC skills. Also, high burst damage heroes can be hard for Nathan. I therefore suggest you be careful against heroes like Selena, Belleric, Eudora, Vil and Aldous. Overall, Nathan is a fine hero at the moment and is definitely one you can play to increase your win rate. The next hero is Layla. Layla is a very strong hero since she has one of the highest DPS of all Marksman heroes. Combined with her high range, she can be very deadly. The only downside of Layla is that she has no escape skills and is dead when any hero manages to come close. But with proper protection, Layla is a true beast and definitely needs a spot on this list. The trick with Layla is to make sure you always hit her first skill. This deals a good amount of damage, but it also increases your movement speed and increases the range of your basic attack. This makes it easy to hit enemies from a big distance, so you can safely take them down. A good Layla understands that you can't miss her first skill. Her second skill is less strong, but can also help her, since it's the only one that has a form of CC. The skill deals damage and slows the enemies by 30%, which isn't a lot, but it's better than nothing. Also, the heroes that are hit by the skill will be marked, and hitting them again will result in more damage and 30% slow effect again. And then, there is her ultimate, which deals a big amount of damage from an even longer range. By casting the skill, Layla shoots an energy blast in front of her, dealing a big amount of damage against all enemies. This skill deals a high amount of damage, but is quite slow. If you can still reach the enemies, try to keep using your basic attack, since this can deal more damage. When you can't reach them with your basic attack anymore, it's time to finish them with your ultimate. Leveling the skill will also increase the range of her basic attack. If the skill is maxed, her basic attack is that long that she's able to hit the turret without getting hit by it. Her ability makes Layla one of the most offensive marksmen. But don't forget that she has very weak mobility. She can easily be countered and therefore a strong tank or fighter can help you a lot. If he manages to protect you very well, Layla is just a killing machine. It's very important you pay close attention on what your team and especially the enemy team chooses. Layla can win her lane easily against a marksman with low basic attack range like Mia and Claude. Also, other low range heroes or fighters are perfect targets for Layla. Therefore, you can also choose her against heroes like Bane, Aurora, Diggy, Estus and Tarisla. She also goes well with heroes that can protect Layla. This way, she can attack the enemies, while they take the hits and remove potential attackers. Layla goes perfect with heroes like Tigreal, Barret, Kufra, Cho and Guinevere. But the big downside is that there are way too many heroes that can counter Layla. She has no chance against heroes that come close easily. Be very careful against heroes like Nathan, Ling, Fanny, Esmeralda, Basia, Candita, Johnson, Atlas and many more. But if there is an opportunity where you can pick her, Layla is one of the best marksman heroes because of her insane high DPS. Then another hero that still is a great pick is Leslie. She also has a high range and damage, just like Layla and Clint. This makes her also one of the best heroes to pick. She is great to poke enemies. After a few seconds, her passive provides her basic attack with a bigger range, increased damage and 40% crit chance. After you use this basic attack, just cast skill 1 and use basic attack again to quickly deal another hit with your basic attack. This results in 2 high hits from a big distance, which can weaken your enemy. If you do this a couple of times, the enemy has to recall or you can try to take it out. This is a great way to weaken the enemy. If the target is out of reach, you can use your ultimate to finish it. By casting the skill, Leslie targets an enemy with her sniper to shoot 4 bullets, which deal higher damage the less HP the target has. Also, the camouflage state from her first skill is quite handy when playing as a marksman. This way, you can escape dangerous situations and become untargetable. Leslie is a wise pick against the low range heroes. Just poke the enemy for a few times and you can finish the target. Therefore, I often choose her against heroes like Freya, Mia, Argus, Jawhead and Cho. She also goes very well with heroes that have strong CC skills. They can stun the target for you and you can safely deal damage. Choose Leslie in combination with heroes like Nella, Lolita, Minotaur and Sylvana. The very mobile heroes are the biggest weakness of Leslie. If they manage to get close, you will have a hard time surviving. Therefore, be careful against Fanny, Ling, Helkert, Hayabusa and Basha. Overall, Leslie is a fairly easy hero to play, but can be quite powerful in the right hands. Then, there's only one hero left to finish this list. The very last one is Beatrix. This hero is currently my favorite hero because of her insane high damage. I love to play her with the green gun that shoots 1 bullet with very high damage. You can easily kill a target in 2 hits, and if you do it very well, you occasionally can one-hit heroes. What I love about her is that she can easily last hit minions. This results in increased gold, which gets you your items faster and therefore makes you stronger. She has 4 guns and she's able to carry 2 of them at a time. Like I said, the green one shoots 1 bullet that deals very high damage. It can be dodged by enemies, so it might be hard to master this gun. Then we have the yellow gun, which is some kind of shotgun. The shotgun can shoot twice from a close distance, which also deals very high damage. I personally am not a big fan of this gun, since a marksman has to stay at a distance. The red gun deals area of effect damage with her bombs that it shoots. This is also a decent gun, since you can deal very high damage in teamfights. Her other gun is one that looks the most like a normal basic attack. This deals a good amount of damage from a decent range. Also, her ultimate changes depending on the gun she carries. Every gun has its own cooldown reduction, so you can cast 4 ultimates in a short time. Beatrix is a great pick against heroes with bad mobility and low HP. This makes sure you can kill the targets easily. I love to choose her against heroes like Estus, Gord, Farsa, Odette and Nella. She's also a wonderful pick with heroes that CC the enemy. Heroes like Tigreal, Sylvana, Nana, Cyclops and Selena are great to have in your team. Her biggest weakness are the heroes with high burst damage. Combined with great mobility, Beatrix can be killed easily. Be careful against heroes like Helkert, Fanny, Gushen, Aldous and Leslie. Overall, Beatrix is a very nice hero and definitely needs a spot in this list. These were the 5 best marksman heroes of season 22. Which one would you add to this list? Let me know in the comment section. Don't hesitate to subscribe to the channel. I promise to provide valuable content that helps you to become better in Mobile Legends. As always, thank you for watching and I'll be seeing you again in the next guide.